Well, hey folks, I'm glad you could join me in Bosco for this Peter, Paul, and Mary mini concert on dulcimer. I'm going to play some original songs of theirs, some well-known and some obscure material. If you know anything about my background in music, I always say that I'm a graduate of the University of Peter, Paul, and Mary. And this has been a favorite workshop at dulcimer festivals, Peter, Paul, and Mary on dulcimer. So I thought I'd bring you this little concert. Originally, it was going to be on Facebook Live, but I got a lot of emails saying, you know, I'm not going to be around, and will you do it again? So I just thought, let me tape it for you. So we're going to wing it here, run straight through, and hope for the best. When I was just a lad of 10, my father said to me, come here and take a lesson from the lovely lemon tree. Don't put your faith in love, my boy, my father said to me. I fear you'll find that love is like the lovely lemon tree. Lemon tree. Flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. One day beneath the lemon tree, love and I did lie, a girl so sweet that when she smiled, the stars rose in her eyes. We passed that summer lost in love beneath the lemon tree, and the music of her laughter was my father's words to me. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. One day she left without a word. She took away the sun, and in the dark she left behind. I knew what she had done. She left me for another. It's a common tale, but true. A sadder man, but wiser now, I sing these words to you. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. Lemon tree, lemon tree. Will Holt song, Lemon Tree. There's a traditional song that the trio recorded on an album called, I think, See What Tomorrow Brings. It's always been one of my favorites. I've actually recorded it once or twice, but never issued it on an album. So I'm glad to do it for you here today, tonight, whenever you're hearing this. And it's called Hangman. Tune. think I see my father coming riding many a mile. Father, have you brought me hope, or have you paid my fee, or have you come to see me hanging from the gallows tree? I have not brought you hope, I have not paid your fee, for I have come to see you hanging from the gallows tree. Slack your ropes, hangman, slack 'em for a while. I think I see my mama coming riding many a mile. Oh, mother, have you brought me home? Or have you paid my fee? Or have you come to see me hanging from the gallows tree? I have not brought you hope, and I have not paid your fee, for I've come to see you hanging from the gallows tree. Slack your ropes, hang and slack 'em for a while. I think I see my brother coming riding many a mile. Oh, brother, have you brought me hope, or have you paid my fee, or have you come to see me hanging from the gallows tree? Well, I have not brought you hope, and I have not paid your fee, for I have come to see you hanging. Slack your ropes, hangman, slack 'em for a while. I think I see my true love coming riding many a mile. Oh, true love, have you brought me hope? Or have you paid my fee? Or have you come to see me hanging from the gallows tree? Yes, I've brought you hope, and I've paid your fee, for I've not come to see you hanging from the gallows tree.
There you go. Schlitz. No, I'm only kidding. It's LaCroix coconut water. Well, you know, when I was just a wee little lad, full of health and joy, my father homeward came one night and he gave to me a toy. Oh, wonder to behold it was, with many colors bright. And the moment I laid eyes on it, it became my heart's delight. It went zip when it moved and when it stopped and when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. Well, first time that I picked it up, I had a big surprise. For right on the bottom were two big buttons that looked like big green eyes. Well, I first pushed one and then the other, then I twisted its lid, and when I set it down again, here's what it did. It went zip when it moved, and when it stopped, and when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, guess I never will. Well, first march left, and then march right, and then right under a chair, and when I looked where it had gone, it wasn't even there. Oh, my father cried, daddy laughed, cause he knew that I would find, when I turned around, my marvelous toy would be trucking on behind.
It went zip when it moved and when it stopped and when it stood still. I never knew what it was, and I guess I never will. Well, I said, well, the years have gone by so quickly it seems, and I had my own little boy, and yesterday I gave to him my marvelous little toy. His eyes nearly popped out of his head, and he gave a squeal of glee. Neither one of us knows what it is, but he loves it just like me. It goes zip when it moves and when it stops and when it stands still. I never knew just what it was, I guess I never will.
Good old Tom Paxton song there, The Marvelous Toy. In, I think, the late 80s, I was making a children's record called Dinosaurs and Dragons. And I wanted to record Puff the Magic Dragon, so I contacted Peter, who I had known for many years at that point, and asked if he would do a duet with me, which he graciously decided yes to. So I went to New York, and we went to his favorite recording studio and did five live takes of it, and we picked one. And you can hear that song, the duet with Peter and I, on Puff the Magic Dragon on iTunes or Amazon or something like that. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu. Oh, little Jackie Paper loved that rascal Puff, and he brought him strings and sealing wax and other fancy stuff. Oh, Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu. Oh, Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu. Well, together they would travel on a boat with billowed sail. Jackie kept a lookout perched on Puff's gigantic tail. Oh, the noble kings and the princes would bow whene'er they came. Pirate ships would lower their flag when Puff roared out his name. Oh, Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and he frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu. Oh, Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and he frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu. You know a dragon lives forever, but not so girls or boys. Painted wings and giant rings make way for other toys. And one gray night it happened, Jackie Paper came no more. Puff that mighty dragon sadly ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow, green scales fell like rain. Puff no longer went to play along the cherry lane, and without his lifelong friend, Puff could not be brave. So Puff, that mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea, and he frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu.
still does. Puff, the magic dragon, lives by the sea, and he frolics in the autumn mist in a land called Hanoli. There you go. Little Puff the Magic Dragon for you. Well, I thought I would sing two Bob Dylan songs that Peter, Paul, and Mary made well known. I recorded actually this concert this morning, and then due to my amazing, brilliant technical head that I have, and I'm really good, I managed to delete the whole frickin' thing. So now it's evening and the temperature's changing. I'm doing this again. But I'm in better voice, so that's good. So we have to do that Ravi Shankar thing, tuning. But don't think twice, it's all right. Version of a Dylan tune, but just enough to make you want more. This is a big dulcimer that was made for me by a friend of mine named Bernd Krause. I call it Bubba. It has these two fretboards. So I thought this would be a perfect song to sing you during this time especially. It's called The Times They're Changing.
Wide, the chance won't
come again. And don't speak too soon, for the wheel's still in spin. And there's no telling who that it's naming. For the loser now, later to win. For the times, they are changing. Come senators and congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall. For he that gets hurt will be he who has the stall. There's a battle outside and it's raging. It'll soon shake your windows and rattle your wall. For the times, they're changing. Curse it's been cast, and the slow one now will later be fast, as the present now will later be last, and the order is rapidly changing. Gotta get out of the new one, and the first one will pass for the time.
Quite a sound this thing has. Bernd Krauss, and he's building actually another one kind of like it for me. So he's selling this one. If anyone likes it, you let me know, and I'll put you in touch with Bernd, and it can be yours. So hold on 1 second. All right. There's a wonderful song that Libba Cotton wrote called Freight Train. And it makes a wonderful dulcimer instrumental. And she developed something called cotton picking. And this is a little of that. Freight Train. Tell you a little story. I met Peter when I was really young, probably about 13. And then later the trio came to Philadelphia, and over a period of time I got to know them. They became friends and mentors. Very, very sweet group. What you see on stage and what you hear musically is really what you get with them. And, of course, Mary Travers passed away, I think, 4 or 5 years ago. But she really was my favorite folk singer. One time she came to Philadelphia during the 7-year period that Peter, Paul, and Mary had broken up. And she played a little club called the Bijou. And I called the guy, Bill, who booked the Bijou. And I said, "Bill, who's opening for Mary?" And he said, "Well, I haven't decided yet." And I said, "Well, please, please put me in."
And I got lucky and he put me in. So we did Thursday through Sunday night. We did two shows a night. And I was very nervous to meet her. And I got to the club and she was finishing her sound check and she got off stage. And I jumped up on the stage and I got to the piano because she had a pianist with her. And I did all my bags are packed. I'm ready to go and I'm standing here outside your door and I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. Kind of a blues version of leaving on a jet plane. And she was heading up the stairs to the dressing room and she leaned her head over the staircase and she said, the first two words I ever heard her speak to me, and I always kidded her about this, it like my heart was a flutter. She leaned her head over and she said in her Lauren Bacall voice, Kevin, you're not singing my hit, right? So there's a wonderful biography of her, sort of an autobiography, actually. I guess you can get it on Amazon. It was written by her friend and mine, Mike Renshaw. I don't remember the name of it, but it's a wonderful book to give you some insights to Mary and the group. So this is for Mary, wherever you are. All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. But the dawn is breaking and it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you wait for me. Hold me like you never let me go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. There's so many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I think of you. Every song I sing for you. When I come back, I'll wear your wedding ring. Oh, kiss me and smile for me. I'll be on my way. Come on, dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the time I won't have to say. Tune written by John Denver. Well, I've got two more for you. Actually, there was some questions that people had written to me, and I thought I'd answer them real quick. They wanted to know if I was going to do any more musical concerts like this, because I don't really post a lot of concerts. Well, I started to do a lot of them on YouTube, so if you like this concert, you can go to my channel, and you can hear all the other stuff that I do. And I'll be posting some more stuff, real interesting stuff, coming up soon. This one I got a kick out of. He said, "Kevin, I got into the dulcimer playing after I heard you in the 70s, back when you had hair." Ain't that nice? Are you still recording for Folkways? No, I'm not recording for Folkways, but all those records, I've got 50 records, but 12 of them are in the Smithsonian, with Folkways Smithsonian. And I do have hair, actually. I shave it. I started to do that when I screwed up my hair right before a TV show I was going to do in Connecticut. I went to Walgreens and I got some hair dye, thinking that I could hide some of the gray coming in. And I completely ruined it, you know. So it hadn't sunk into my skin. So I was able to shave my head, and it looked the way it looked. And I've kept it this way ever since. It's kind of manageable, you know. And the other one was, oh, do I have any songbooks? I do, but you have to find them on eBay. Occasionally, when I do dulcimer festivals, I bring a tablature of new songs. This song was written by Hetty West. It's called 500 Miles. And there was a little coffee house in Brattleboro, Vermont, called the Chelsea House Cafe. Really lovely spot, run by Carol Levin and her partner. And she invited me once to be the opening act for Hetty West, and I said I'd do it. Because I wanted to hear Hetty sing this song. And it pulled into Henniker, New Hampshire. No, Brattleboro, Vermont, I'm sorry. Around 2:30 in the morning. And you had to hope that there was somebody getting off the train to drive you wherever you needed to go. So I sang this for Hetty, and she... If you miss the train I'm on, you will know that I am gone. You can't hear the whistle blow 100 miles. 100 miles, 100 miles, 100 miles, 100 miles. You can't hear the whistle blow 100 miles. Not a shirt on my back, not a penny to my name. Lord, I can't go back home this way. The whistle blow pretty song. She played it on the banjo. Very fast. So I had a little Peter story, I had a little Mary story, and of course we can't leave out Noel. Paul's real name is Noel. He had took on the middle name Paul to make it sound better, Peter, Paul, and Mary, rather than Peter, Noel, and Mary. And I had moved to Kansas for a year and a half to work on a project. And 2 weeks after I got there, Peter and Noel came and gave a concert. This was several years after Mary had passed away. So I went to the show, kind of astounded that they would come to Kansas, you know, where in the area I was. And anyway, I went to the show, and afterwards, Noel and I went out and we had some drinks at his hotel. And he brought up this idea of doing a project with a woman who played synthesizer and dulcimer, because synthesizer and dulcimer had never been done. And I just kind of chalked it off to, you know, backstage talk. And about a month later, he calls me on the phone, and he had been driving and was listening to an album I made called Awakenings. And he said, "We got to do something with this." And I said, "Well, what would you want to do?" And he said, "Let's take some of the songs from Awakenings, write some new songs, and we'll do a whole new album. And I've got this guy named Michael McGinnis who plays amazing synthesizer. And I'll put it on my record label, and you know, we'll make it a fun project, and we'll call it Reawakening." So I wrote a whole bunch of songs, and one of the songs I wrote was called Dorothy. And he liked it, and he said, "But it needs a bridge." And I said, "Well, I don't know. You have any ideas?" And he came up with the bridge, "Don't Mind the Man Behind the Curtain. Smoke and mirrors is his game. Take the time to find your answer. Isn't that the reason that you came?" And I think he came up with that because I had written the song, which wasn't very good, called Smoke and Mirrors. But anyway, this is a song that he and I wrote together. There's two versions. One of them is on Reawakening, and then the last album I just did, called The Deviant Dulcimer, has an extended version of Dorothy, because when I got to California, I wrote another verse. So I thought I'd sing you a song that Noel and I wrote together. Decides to move there. I said, "I've got a feeling it'll be respite. I'm packing up my Toto and all my affairs." I said, "I've got a feeling all kinds of things are gonna turn around and come around and be what I need. Just like Dorothy landing in Oz, riding the tornado into make believe. Dorothy, are you there? I could use some company. Don't forget to leave those ruby slippers for me. I need a fast track for making my way back from the lion and the scarecrow and that tin man." Well, it all turned into quite a cosmic Kansas. Who would have guessed? Who could have known? And no one would believe this crazy life I'm living between the yellow brick road and the twilight zone. Well, I packed my bags, headed back to California. You know there's really no place like home. You gotta have the brains, the courage, and the heart to follow your rainbow wherever you roam. Dorothy, are you there? I could use some company. Don't forget as Dorothy. Well, I hope you've enjoyed that. I do have a Patreon page. You know, people say, well, where can I hear your music? And I come up with two or three different things a week, or a month rather, and then I send them out to people. So if you're interested in that, you can go to patreon.com/KevinRoth and sign up. And there's also a wonderful new project I'm going to be coming out with soon, and it's called What Really Matters. And it's about discovering what's really important to you and finding a life that you love and creating a living doing that. So if you're interested in knowing more about that, do send me a message. Feel free to share this video if you'd like. And a lot of people wrote to me and said, you're going to have Bosco. So this is Bosco, and he is the best. Did you like the concert? Give me a kiss if you like the concert. Come on, quick. No, see, he's like that. He's stubborn. Later he'll kiss me. But say hello to everybody. He's a little miniature dachshund. And look how cute. There's Bosco. There is Bosco. And he's just a real cutie. He's usually very affectionate, but it's a little later for him tonight. So anyway, I hope you're staying safe during this whole thing. I hope you're taking time to rethink your life. There's a song on YouTube I wrote about this called Long Pause. Something I wrote from listening to the Rachel Maddow show. I think you'll enjoy. So be well. I think I finished just in time because the neighbors are coming home with their pizzas. So thanks for watching, and we will be singing and yakking at you again.